please stand and greet the Chief Justice and welcome him. Please be seated. Good evening, a very warm welcome to each one of you who has joined us at the book launch of Blood Sanders, The Great Forest Heist. A special welcome to the Honorable Chief Justice of India, Justice N.V. Ramana Rao Garu, who joins us live from Delhi. And also our panel guests here, M.V. Krishna Rao, former DG of the Sashastra Seema Bal, Mr. P. Raghuveer, who retired as Principal Chief Conservator of Forest, and Professor Madhabhusi Sridhar, Dean at the School of Law, Mahindra University, and also former Information Commissioner, Chief Information Commissioner. My name is Uma Sudhir, and I work as Executive Editor with NDTV, but I'm here today in my capacity as a friend of Sudhakar Reddy Udumala, who I've known for some 20 years now, I think. My very first impression when I met him first in Vijayawada was of an eager beaver, keen to do everything, learn everything, do everything. And to this day, he actually remains that way, and that's why he's this hotshot reporter that we'll talk about. Today's evening, we will go into today's evening with two sessions. The first session with the Honorable Chief Justice actually unveiling and e-launching the physical book that we are all eager to read. I have had some opportunity to actually take a quick read, and I can tell you this is a very, very well-researched book that documents all that we want to know about this unique national treasure. And I'm glad that he did this book, because I can't think of anybody else better suited to talk about the different aspects of this book, whether it is the importance of it as part of the biodiversity or the criminal nexus and the political equations, and also giving us an international picture of how this happened. So it's a very good piece of journalistic book, I must say, which sticks to factuals. So the first session will be this, and the second session we are hoping to have a animated conversation with our esteemed panel of guests. Thank you, Chief Justice, sir, first of all, for joining us and taking out this time, and we are really honored to have you with us. I'm going to invite journalist author Sudhakar to, in fact, introduce this book and what he calls its hero, the Red Sanders Tree, he often says is the hero of this book. Sudhakar, of course, is right now editor investigation in the Times of India, Hyderabad, and he's been a journalist for 20 years, wrote articles on flora, fauna. He's a microbiologist, he's a lawyer, he's God knows what all he has done, many, many different things under his hat, in fact. And that's where the eagerness of wanting to learn and remain a student all his life, that's something that I think he does fantastically well. And that's why he's a UNICEF Media Award winner and also alumnus of the IVLP program in the US and a Chevening Fellow as well. He has been reporting and tracking smuggling operations in these areas, just like he has been I should say tracking several important crime stories in this part of the country. And I'm going to invite Sudhakar to actually tell us a brief introduction about why he thought he needed to do this book at this juncture. For a working journalist, it's actually very challenging to, in fact, take out time in order to be able to do books, and that he has managed to do it while holding a full-time job as a journalist, 24/7 job. That's to Sudhakar. So, I invite you.
Thank you, Uma Sudhir Karan. Today's chief guest of the book release event, Honorable Justice N.V. Ramana Garu, the Chief Justice of India, the guests of honor, Sri M.V. Krishna Rao Garu, Raghuveer Garu, Professor Madhabhusi Sridhar Garu, and moderator of the event, Uma Sudhir Garu. I welcome you, all of you, to the release event. So I'm honored, sir, N.V. Ramana Garu, you have come here despite hectic schedule and all your engagements. I want all of you to clap for the CJ for coming here. Sir, as a journalist for 2.5 decades, I have covered the subject of Red Sanders smuggling for 3 prominent newspapers where I worked and working currently. As the figures quoted and confirmed by Mr. Raghuveer Garu, in the past 2 decades, 15,000 metric tons of Red Sanders wood was seized. And going by the market value in China and elsewhere, each ton of Red Sanders is worth 1 crore. So that means it's 15,000 crore worth of Red Sanders has been seized. However, only 10 to 20% of wood is seized, indicating that worth of red sandal trees that were felled would obviously be several times more, running into a few hundreds of thousands of crores. Red sandals is perhaps the only tree after sandalwood to witness the fiercest of battles, resulting in scores of deaths. The tree's history is draped in blood, sweat, and violence. Blood Sanders, the Great Forest Heist, that's my book today, Honorable CJ is going to unveil, is the first comprehensive publication that delves into multiple aspects of this highly endemic to Rayalaseema, and endangered plant species. After realizing the size of illegal smuggling market and the kingpins against whom a red corner notice is still alive and operating from Dubai and elsewhere out of India, which the agencies are yet to get him, these smugglers are plundering the biological wealth of the nation. That made me, I felt that I should write a comprehensive book on this subject to bring out certain kind of unknown facts. 3 years ago, I started working on this project. I have done a lot of research and investigation on ground and online. So tracking not only the smugglers and their current activities, I also walked extra miles along with the combing parties of police, foresters and Red Sanders anti-smuggling task force into the deep Seshachalam forest for a first-hand understanding of the subject. Because I'm a son of a farmer, like Honorable CJ Garu, we agriculture family, so I had certain kind of inbuilt body strength. I had climbed the hills and harsh terrain 26 kilometers on foot and lived in the woods on dark nights and sunny days. I tried to comprehend how the organized criminal network operates to plunder the Red Sanders. As I've been speaking, Red Sanders, though endemic to Rayalaseema, it's a pride species of entire nation. In this book, Red Sanders, the Great Forest Heist, I attempted to give a comprehensive account of organized criminal network and operation behind Red Sanders smuggling that starts in dense Seshachalam forest and ends in the homes of China and Japan. I confess that this is not a literary work. It's a factual account of what happens around this multi-billion racket. And at the same time, the perspective of woodcutters' lives and conditions in Tamil Nadu is also brought into this book. I visited multiple locations in Andhra, Tamil Nadu, and Karnataka, where the smugglers are based to bring out the facts. It's highly dangerous to visit certain areas like Katikinahalli in Bangalore and Red Hills in Chennai, from where the mid-level and national-level smugglers operate. Honorable CJ Garu, I made a sincere attempt to differentiate between illegal woodcutters and smuggling operatives and kingpins. I have given a little stress on dramatization but focused on facts, but only facts. This book is a first step to understand the complex network that drives this illegal trade across borders, a number of players involved from top to bottom. I tried to explain various stages of smuggling, from hiring woodcutters to the logs ending up in China. The Chinese connection and money laundering aspects were also highlighted as one of the chapters in this book. I have written this book with information and research from multiple sources. Several of the incidents mentioned are my first-hand experiences and information I've gathered to report on smuggling activities for the last 20 years in various state and national newspapers. Documents both in public sphere and otherwise, such as the ones obtained from different law enforcement agencies, I tried to bring in to light many aspects of the smuggling racket which are hitherto not known. I faced a fair amount of non-cooperation from the current police and forest officials in procuring information for the book. Interviews I have conducted with various incumbent and retired high-level police and forest officials and smugglers have contributed greatly to the work. Extensive scientific and historical research papers published about Red Sanders dating back to the beginning of the decade have helped me to provide a deeper perspective on the allure of the Red Sanders. Many newspaper articles and online sources have also added to the database of information. Honorable CJ Garu, before I conclude, I would like to stress upon the need to protect Red Sanders from extinction. And there is a need for an intervention from the highest level. Red Sanders is one of the unique gifts of the Mother Nature to Andhra Pradesh and as well as the country. let's all pledge to protect this species for the prosperity. Thank you very much, sir.
If you may now invite the Honorable Chief Justice to launch the boat, but before that, I have the privilege of actually saying a few words, introducing the Chief Justice who has made us all so proud when he took over as the 48th Chief Justice of India in April this year. Justice Nuthalpathy Venkat Ramana's nearly 4-decade-long career in law has seen him practicing in at least 2 high courts, the Supreme Court, a number of administrative tribunals, and the panel counsel of various government organizations specializing in constitutional, criminal, service, and interstate river laws. He also served as the acting Chief Justice of Andhra Pradesh High Court and the Chief Justice of Delhi High Court before being elevated as a judge of the Supreme Court of India. As Sudhakar was mentioning, he also is from, in fact, an agricultural family at Punavaram village in Andhra Pradesh, Krishna district. And from there, he rose to such heights, and matter of a little pride that he has also been a journalist at some point in time, I'm told, for a short period of time, and that makes us really, really proud. And I also hear from my colleagues that, as we all know, in fact, during the Chief Justice tenure is when the maximum number of appointments of judges has, in fact, happened. And that's actually something we need to clap to, because many years, many things don't move, but when he came, and the other important thing I'm told about the way he did that was that it was a very, very democratic process. Insiders tell me that it has never been as democratic as when Chief Justice Ramana was there, those selection processes when they were carried out, and the record number of judges that we have, which really helps the entire process of justice itself. Thank you so much, Ramana Garu, and we are so honored that you could take out time for this unveiling of the book and e-launching of this book. So I invite our guests here, panel guests, Sridhar Garu, Krishnada Garu, and Raghuveer Garu also to physically unveil. Before that, I would request you to get a physical copy, and we could probably have the e-launch of the book. Does it happen?
One second.
Many congratulations, and thank you so much, Chief Justice Sir, for unveiling the book for us. I would request you to speak a few words. We are all eagerly waiting to hear you, sir.
Udumula Sudhakar Reddy garu, Professor Madamoshi Sridhar garu, Sri M. E. Krishnarao garu, P. Raghuveer garu, Ms. Uma Sudhir, other distinguished guests, friends from media. The book Blood Sanders that we are holding in our hands today is the result of diligent research and a great amount of hard work put in by Sri Udumula Sudhakar Reddy. He has been tracking this subject as a professional news reporter for nearly 2 decades. He traveled extensively in the habitat of red sanders, which is a difficult terrain to walk through. He had first-hand interaction with the key players of the smuggling racket and also those who struggle to enforce the law. I think he's the most qualified persons to deal with the subject. When he first approached me for this event, I had no choice but to say yes for more than one reason. Firstly, I knew him as a journalist from his formative days as a crime reporter. I'm happy to note that he rose to the rank of editor in a leading English daily. Secondly, I and his uncle, Udumala Jojireddy, were together as students of RVVN College, Amaravati. We stayed together in the very same hostel. He used to be the leader of Student Federation of India and a progressive student leader. We used to travel crossing the river of Krishna, walking from our village to Amaravati sometimes during holidays. These are the rich experiences in life. His father, Sri Udumala Rayapuredi Garu, a few years senior to me, is an agriculturist who hailed from Jagannathapuram village, which is just adjacent to my native village, Ponnavaram. Ooru vada guttostunnayi, chinna naati mitrulu, sneehitulu andaru guttukostunnaru, maa ooru velalani anukuntunnaru, tarvane velli ekkada unnatuvanti mitrulandarni kalusukodaniki prayatnam chestanu. As described by Sudhakar, his father Rayapuredi Garu is well known in our area for his integrity and resilience. I could not have said no, this worthy son of a worthy